Hey guys, well today I bring you a full tour and review on our 2014 Ford Escape Titanium. This video will entail basically everything you'd want to know about the truck, so let's get started. This truck has Ford's smart key access. It has remote start, so what you do is press lock to ensure the vehicle is locked. Press remote start. And to shut it off, press the remote start button once. Coming to the door, it does have the smart key access, like I said. Push the black button to lock. Put your hand behind the handle to unlock. Coming inside the door, you do have soft touch on the door. Hard touch down here. Door handles, windows, mirrors, window lockout. You have your lock and unlock. You also have your seat presets, three being mine. As you could see it. Sorry about some wind noise also. Getting inside. You have your charcoal black leather interior with your sterling gray metallic exterior. Now to start the Escape, you press the brake, you press the button on the dash to start. This truck has 8,086 miles on it. Get the air going because it's very hot in here. Move the vents away from the camera. And as you can see, it is 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So, we'll go ahead and turn on the headlights. Fog's already on. Now if you have the smart key in your pocket like I do, and you walk out of the vehicle with it, after you shut the door it will beep twice, letting you know that the key is not in the vehicle, and it will chime inside the car. So I'll leave the key in here so that it does not beep at me. Ford redesigned the Escape in the 2013 model year, going to more of a car-based platform. This truck is based on the Ford Focus. Just have the minivan style wipers. This truck rides on Conti Pro Contact tires. They are 19-inch alloy rims. Actually, no, they are 19-inch Luster nickel wheels. They have a lot of tread left on them. They have your turn signal mirrors. I did wash this truck about 3 days ago. You have your tinted windows. Easy fuel filler. This does not have the panoramic sunroof. Does not have all-wheel drive. It has backup sensors. The camera. power liftgate. It also has the foot activated feature. Under here, you have the spare tire, which was used once. You have your jack, your thing for the fuel tank, you have your amp, and we have a little TD Bank snow ice remover. And this clip also comes off. You latch it up here to get your spare tire out. Put that back later. You also have a 12 volt power outlet, halogen bulb light for the trunk. You have a code hook, another code hook. These indents would be for the cargo cover. We do not have it, so that's why it's not in here. And you have your sub for your 8-speaker audio system from Sony. Shut the trunk, press this, but also you can adjust the setting by just pulling it to where you want it. Holding the button, it will chime at you. And then once you open the trunk again, it will open to that preferred setting. We like it all the way up, so as you can see, it beeped. I'll just shut it up. Now, how the foot activated sensor works, I do not have the key with me, but you just swipe your foot under the rear bumper and it will open for you, and then you swipe it again to shut it. You have your rear wiper, washer fluid, brake light, your Sirius antenna. This truck looks beautiful in the sun. Now, the wheel that was replaced was this tire right here. So that's why this tire has the most tread. So just a tread check on this one, there is fairly a lot of tread left. We'll go hop inside. But first, before we check out the inside, we'll pop the hood. This vehicle is powered by Ford's 2-liter EcoBoost 4-cylinder engine that puts out 231 horsepower and 271 pound-feet of torque. It has a 15.1-gallon fuel tank, and it gets to 60 in around 7 seconds. So checking out the interior, shut off the lights. Coming to your gauges, these are the same gauges that come out of the Ford Focus. You have your tach, your speedo, and your fuel and engine temperature. Then in the middle you have your driver information system. You have your temperature up there, trip, park, reverse, neutral, drive, and sport, north, south, east, west, and your odometer. The little car over there shows if you have your headlamps on and your fog lamps. That's without fogs, that's with fogs. There's your brights, and that's flashing someone. You also have your turn signals, and then tap for 3 blinks. That's good for lane changes, I see. Moving up one setting, you have your speedometer. You have your average fuel economy, instant fuel economy, trip timer, trip odometer, and distance to empty. Hey, you have your turn signal stop. And like I said, tap for 3 blinks. This controller here controls that. It's your cruise control. Your audio controls. Your sync lady. Home button. Or home screen button. Hang up, answer, and your information. These are your variable intermittent speed wipers. These are the minivan style. And you have your rear wiper. Push up once for intermittent. One more for just on, and one more for high. And then just push it down once, just for a quick wipe. Push forward for the back wiper washer, and pull forward for the front wiper washer. Push button start button. Coming over to the My 4 touch screen. It is a fairly good screen, I have to say. I'm just going to connect my phone now. It is connected to my mother's at the moment. So that's my mother's iPhone. It's mine. That's my dad's. And she is the favorite phone. And while we're in this screen, I'll go over the phone. You have your devices, add device, connect, disconnect, info, favorite, delete device. And you just highlight the one that you want to delete, and then you hit delete. Here you have phone, quick dial, phone book, history, messages, settings. Here you have your dialing pad. When you're on the phone, you can do privacy, hold, mute, join calls. This is to take away numbers. Dial, and this, if you have a picture on your phone, it will come up on here. Here you have your audio. This AM.
Put in one. Con Ed is reducing.
FM. Sirius. We do not have it hooked up right now. CD. What's in here? Oh, this is the Grease CD. Here you have USB, Bluetooth stereo, SD card, and AV in. Do a little sound demo. I wish you'd save a little bit just for me. Addictive or possessive, girl. Call it passive or aggressive. Turn my machine music up, and I'm puffing my chest. Now I'll do a CD demo. Now I will do the Bluetooth audio. Make sure your phone is connected to sync. mine is. Or you can connect it without your phone being actually connected to Sing. Just hit Bluetooth stereo. Just trying to connect to my dad's right now. So I hit cancel. Hit Bluetooth stereo again. Takes a little while to load. As you can see, it's trying to connect to my dad's again. Click on mine. And it will automatically start playing a song. See, it's connecting. Even though my phone is connected to Sync, it's going to try to connect mine again because Bluetooth audio is a separate system. So I will pick a song.
My one solution is my queen, cause she stays strong.
Yeah, now yeah. In the audio menu, you have options, repeat and shuffle.
All these other girls are tempting, but I'm empty when you're gone. They say, do you need me? Do you think I'm pretend? Do I make you feel like cheating?
As you can hear, being Bluetooth audio, it is very basic, has a very heavy impact.
She is always right there.
Coming to the next screen, it is navigation. I do not have the card in right now because I do not want you to know the street I live on. But that will be in a separate video. Here you have climate. Very different temperatures. Your zones. You have your automatic setting. Max defroster. AC, max AC. Recycle and dual. The information is just sync information, and it will come up that there is an SD card fault for navigation. You have where am I, apps, calendar, travel link, services. Calendar is actually very neat. I thought it would be neat, but you can't actually enter appointments and stuff, it just tells you the calendar. I read the dates. Here you have your source, hazards, your radio on and off, your knob for volume, tuning, tracks, or seeking, sound. This tells you if your vehicle is locked or unlocked. Orange means locked, no light means unlocked. Coming down here, you have your climate, auto with your temperature. Now if I change the temperature, this one's on 60, or low, that's on 63. If I hold down the driver one, they both go to the same temperature. I know you can't really see because the shifter's in the way. Here you have AC, different zones over here, recycle, off, max defrost, max AC. Here you have your trunk, fan speed, rear defroster. Press this, open your trunk. Press again to shut it. Coming up here, random dollar. You have your mirror with your light. Safety precaution things. Leave your home link. Hold the preset one. It will shut your garage. Hold it again, and it will stop and open it up. Little thing I bought from my mom with a veteran flower. To hold it, To set it up, I will make a separate video on that. Your auto dimming mirror, sunglass holder. Here's your Ford My Color. This is to the brightness of the lights. This is to turn on your cabin lights. This is the different colors. Not to turn your lights on, but to turn the ambient lighting on. Your headlamps or parking lamps have to be on. I'm trying to think of, trying to see where you could see it. If you look in there, it's very light, but change the color. You just press it to keep cycling. I apologize if this isn't the most professional video. Automatic driver, passenger, and the back passenger window, so all four automatic. Coming further down, you have your parking brake. Put your foot on the brake, pull it up. Then to release it, put your foot on the brake, press the button, pull up, and it releases. You have your 5-level heated seats, 12-volt power outlet. You have your cup holders with my phone and the key. Coming in here, you have a little tray. You also have a fairly deep console. You have your SD card, 2 USBs, AV inputs. Just have another 12 volt in there. Card and USB storage. And then you just snake the wire through there. It is pretty sure-footed. Not the best, but it's pretty sure-footed. Coming to the shifter, you have park, reverse, neutral, drive, and sport. You have your sport selection. You have your window lockout, like I said before. You have your lights. Off, parking, on, automatic. To turn your fog lights on, or to make your fog lights come on while you're in automatic, turn the headlamps on, press the fog light button. It will display on the screen and put them back in auto. And then when the headlamps come on, it will look like this at night. And it will look like that on the screen. Shut the truck down. Take the key. Go to the back seat. Now coming to the back seat. Now sitting in the back seat, I am only 5'4", so my seat is pretty far up. But when my father sits, he is 6 feet, and I have about this much room. When he sits back here, you have two tweeters, window switches, and another speaker. Back vents. Shut them and open them. 150-volt household outlet. You have another tweeter. And you have regular speaker, two map pockets, you have an armrest, two cup holders, Now I already showed you the trunk, but I will show you the foot activated feature. Have the key with you, swipe your foot under, and it will open. Shut it, swipe your foot under, and it will shut. You have your easy fuel filler gas cap like I showed you before. Coming here, you have storage as well as on the other side and in the front doors. Here you have, under here, a little storage cubby. Now, I did hear that they eliminated that for 2015, which is a pretty big downfall, because we use this a lot, and especially in the winter. Coming into here, you have your glove box. You have your fake vents on the side. Well, guys, that concludes my full tour and review on our 2014 Ford Escape Titanium. If you have any questions about this specific vehicle, or the Focus, or about any of my videos, just leave a comment below, DM me on Instagram, or email me. Please like, subscribe, and comment. And follow me on all of my social media. And that's it. See you guys later.